Indiana's always been a home for motorsports. It dates back to the Indianapolis 500 and long history that's involved with it. At CAPE, our goal within the motorsports at CAPE is to work at all levels within the race industry and the motorsports industries. We currently do a lot of testing for some of the premier leagues. We want to continue that, but we want to bring testing down to the lower levels, and that's really an example of what we're doing tonight with this sprint car crash.
What we have is a sprint car, and what we're going to do is perform a crash test on it. Because we're going to do a crash test that simulates that first event where he wrecks into the back or the side of another car, or he might glance off the outside of the wall.
The technology on the chassis hasn't really changed that much in about 20 years, and the speeds have got greater and greater. And we're here just to learn as much as we can about the structure of the chassis and how it stands up at what stages.
So we have to put instruments on the vehicle to measure the G-force. And the crash test dummy has instruments throughout. And that feeds a signal to a data recorder, which is also known as a black box. And what this does is it takes a measurement 20,000 times a second. Crash test was a big success. I think the theme is the way that the chrome moly tubing absorbed the impact. Pretty much all the damage is from here forward. So that's a good thing. We'll watch all the videos in great detail, try to understand, you know, when things occur in time relative to one another. We'll study the dummy data. Then we're going to move forward to doing the next crash test.
We evaluated a lot of on-track accidents through videos and saw that in many cases a sprint car will lose control, either crash into another car or an obstacle with its front, and then flip up and go airborne and then crash into something else. And this is why we conducted two tests. First, the frontal crash, and then second, the crash with the roof into the wall.
We've always been a niche market test house, and we're very good at that. The expertise that we have is in that ability, the flexibility, and the responsiveness that we're able to provide our customers. So the motorsports industry fits very well within that kind of commercial world and that niche world that we've worked in. We're exploring new areas, and we can take those new areas and develop additional safety, whether it's new specs or new products that meet that requirement, that's going to provide additional safety to drivers and to passengers in whatever vehicle they might be in. And that's really our benefit. It's not just doing a test, but it's helping people to develop their capabilities and improve their products at the end of the day.